Good morning. Let me get this going for you. Awesome. Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I am doing well. All right. Let's talk about those dumbbells really quick. Did you have your 8-pound dumbbells, right?
Yeah, that's all I have at home. But when I'm at the gym, I use 15s and 20s. So okay. I'm trying to figure out how to like add weight. I saw today that we're only doing single arms. So I figure I can try to put both of them in one hand. I practiced and it worked. So.
Yeah, you can totally do that. Good morning, Adair. Yeah, you can totally do that, Cielo. Oh, Adair's on mute. Another way that we could do, Cielo, with the with playing around with reps is we can slow down the tempo.
Okay.
Also, so that's another thing that we could do. Cool. All right, here we go. We got Adair coming in. Good morning, Adair. Good morning, Becky.
Hi.
What's up, you guys? Hey, so I tried something new, and I want to kind of get some feedback from you guys on adding some music. I'm going to try something really quick. I'm going to make sure it's not too loud. And then you guys tell me kind of where we're at and how that works for you guys. All right. How's that volume? Is that pretty loud or is that okay?
I don't hear anything.
Yeah, we don't hear it. I don't hear anything.
You don't hear anything?
Scott, you have to share it. Use the share button if you're playing music. Then.
Oh, all right. Well, I shared Zoom the screen, but I guess you get to see the screen.
Yeah.
Yeah, but if when you do share, hit the share and then it'll say share music or something like that.
Oh, okay.
You click on the screen that has your Spotify playing.
Okay. I got the video. Okay, I got you. Here we go.
But it shouldn't take away the screen.
Okay. How's that?
The lower. A little bit.
Yeah. All right. I'll play with that again some other time. That's like on my lowest of my low right there. So, well, good morning, guys.
Good morning. My request for you is that when you have someone demonstrating, you remember to pin their video because otherwise I can't really see what you're saying. Do it like that.
Okay, I could do that.
Okay.
So.
Especially when it's.
Do you get my text this morning, Nick?
Yeah, I'm headed out for a run.
Good. I was going to say, have a good run, bro.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay, so just pin video. Okay.
Of the person who's demoing.
Cool, let me try something real quick. So if I am pinning somebody, I'm going to pin Becky right now. That's all on Becky, right? Boom. Awesome.
Not working.
Wait.
I don't have it. Yeah.
No. Nope.
You don't see yellow?
No.
What we see is you.
We just see you when you're talking. I think, how did I make it work before?
I think when someone starts speaking, Zoom recognizes that and then pulls their face or their video to be in the
video. Perfect. Yeah, let's check that out really
host,
quick.
The host.
Check that out, Becky. You want to say something? Boom, hello. Boom. Does everybody see Becky now?
Am I pinned?
But you're not pinned. There's a way that the host can highlight someone without them having to be speaking.
Man. When I feel like I'm getting I'm new. What's that?
I said, it's technology, man. We'll get it.
I know. So if I was to spotlight Becky right there.
Yes. That's how you do it. That's how you do it. Spotlight.
Cool.
Hey,
everyone. Yeah. All right, you guys. Hey, well, good morning. Let's go through the workout today. Nick, have a great run.
Thanks.
Good morning, Dan, Adair, Cielo, and Becky. Boom, boom,
wait,
boom,
Nick,
boom.
Can you page it back for me?
Yeah. All right. So How is logging in your sugar wad workouts? All good? Pretty simple? Pretty good?
Yeah.
Gotta do that.
Okay. You see you need to do that?
Yeah.
All right. Well, cool, guys. Let's go ahead. Let's spread yourself out. We're going to go ahead and start warming up. We're going to do our morning 5-minute warm-up. And we're going to be doing jumping jacks. Dan, if you want to do just kind of like a stationary high knee, right? We don't want anything too dynamic. And what we're going to do, you guys, is we're going to go back and forth, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off, just to kind of get that heart rate moving a little bit. The two movements that we're going to do is going to be jumping jacks. And then, Becky, if you don't mind me, have you show, let me spotlight your video real quick. If you don't mind doing an up down for us, just nice and smooth. Yeah. Just jumping out, high plank. And then the other option would be stepping out. Yeah. Let's say we're not bounding. Boom. Beautiful. And here's the cool thing. Cool, Becky. Thank you. Here's the cool thing about the up down is don't even worry about the jump or the clap. We're just going to reach for the ground, step out or jump out, step up. And then you're just going to stand all the way up and don't even worry about anything else, you guys. All right. So let us do this, you guys. Get set. We're going to start off with our jumping jacks for 20 seconds. And we're going to go back and forth for 5 full rounds. All right. Everybody ready? All right. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and begin. We're going to start with jumping jacks. And then we're going to treat it like Tabata. So we'll go 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. All right, and 3, 2, 1, and rest. We're going to rest 10 seconds and then go right into those up downs. And 3, 2, 1, and here we go. We're just thinking about warming up, getting our hips warm, getting that back warm. There we go. 5 seconds. In 3, 2, 1, and rotate. Okay, so that's going to be set one, everybody. We're going to go right back into those jumping jacks in 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Yeah, I need to figure out that volume thing where it was blasting like crazy on my side so that I lowered the volume super, super low, but then it was super loud on your side too. So 3, 2, 1, and rotate. All right, here we go. Up, downs in 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Dan, if we want to switch up those high knees also, we could go lateral steps. Just kind of get that opposite direction from up and down. All right, in 3, 2, 1, and rotate. We're going to go right back to those jumping jacks. And 3, 2, 1, and here we go. All right, 10 seconds, everybody. And 3, 2, 1, and rotate. Three, two, one, and here we go, up, downs. Again, we're jumping out or stepping out. There we go. Three, two, one, and rotate. Okay, we go back to those jumping jacks. And 3, 2, 1, and begin. All right, 10 seconds, everybody. and three, two, one, and rotate. Three, two, and here we go. Five seconds. Three, two, one, and rotate. All right, you guys, we got one more set of this. Three, two, and here we go. Here we go, there we go. Three, two, one, and rotate. One more series of those up downs. Three, two, and here we go. Ten seconds, everybody. And stop. Nicely done. So I'm thinking something, you guys. I want to kind of go out of order. Is I'd like to have our and maybe how about this? Let me ask you guys what you guys would like to do. We've been missing out our finishers, and I was wondering, would you guys like to kind of go from warm up to our finisher, or would you like to just kind of get into everything and then use our finisher as our finisher?
I know, right?
What's up in there?
I said, let's try the finisher.
All right, let's do it, you guys. So what we're going to do is we are going to lay on our backs. And Becky, if you don't mind me using you as a demo, we're going to do max flutter kicks, okay, for 5 minutes. And every time that we stop fluttering our feet, like our feet hit the ground, then we're just going to turn over and we're just going to do 5 push-ups. So I am going to spotlight Becky, everybody. So hands are going to be underneath your butt, pretty much at your sacrum, right? So that's going to be that back support. And then from here, go ahead and stick your legs out, Becky. Yeah, and we're just going to flutter kick, right? Just flutter, 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 right? And we could possibly make them a little bit better, bigger. But the big thing is we don't want the heels touching the floor. And then once Becky's done, whoo, she puts her feet on the ground. And then she's just going to flip on over. And then she's going to go right into a push-up, right? All the way down, all the way up. Cool. Thanks, Becky. Becky, everybody. All right. So, everybody, let's go ahead. Let's get on our backs. And we are going to go ahead and start this. Again, we're going to go for 5 minutes. And that give yourself a goal of kind of how long you're going to be in it, or just until you're kind of burning. Okay? All right. I'm going to have that clock all set up, you guys. Everybody give me a thumbs up when we're ready. All right. Three, two, one, and here we go. The closer we keep those feet to the ground, sometimes that puts a little bit of extra pressure on our back. So that's why we're going to put our hands underneath that tailbone, sacrum. And we're just hanging out. We're in 20 seconds, you guys. I'm going to give you guys, let you guys know at 30-second increments. Three, two, that's 30 seconds. Awesome, you guys. Nice. Yeah, I was thinking like this would be kind of something, another extended warm-up. Sometimes that warm-up gets in and we kind of get at it, and I like to be super warm when I get moving. Nice job, you guys. We are almost to minute one. There we go. Already into minute one. Nice and smooth. Really bracing that midsection tight. If you feel yourself arching a little bit, right, you can always lift those legs up. Your hip flexors are gonna start to be on fire, guys. We're at minute 30 already. Good job, Becky. Good job, Cielo. Nice, Dan and Adair. Looking good, looking good. We're almost there. We're at 2 minutes, you guys. All right, there we go. Remember, anytime you stop, there we go. Cielo's taking that break again. Nice. You can always go hand release push-ups, you guys, off the deck if that's helpful. Okay, you guys, we're about halfway done. And again, you can always catch your breath a little bit longer, shake everything out, and then go right back into it. Nice, Dan. All right, 2 minutes left, you guys. There we go, Dan. You got it. Okay, 90 seconds, everybody. Well, good job, you guys, for being here this morning. Kicking off our morning right. Taking care of you. Come on, here we go. Those hip flexors, Cielo, huh? Yep. All right, you guys, we have 1 minute left. Here we go. Almost there. Looking good, Dan. Looking good, Adair. Way to move. All right, 45 seconds. Nice, yeah. Once those hip flexors start to get on super fire, I don't know if that's a real word, but you bend those knees a little bit and you just make that scissor kick a little bit bigger. Gives the hip flexors a little bit of a relief, especially the back. All right. 20 seconds, everybody. We're almost there. You got it. 10 seconds. Almost there. Here we go in 5, 4, 3, 2, and stop. Nicely done. All right, guys, grab a quick drink of water really quick. Let's come back to the comment section just to check out the workout, what it's going to look like today. So we do have single arm presses today. All right, so we are going to be doing some floor pressing. So that's just going to be like a bench press without a bench. So that's us being, that's us going to lay on the floor. And then we're going to be doing bent over rows. Again, single arm bent over rows. So Becky, I don't know would you be able to do the demo today?
Hi.
Huh?
I don't know if I'll do it right, but I can try.
All right. I have faith in you. All right. So what we're going to do is, if you can give us a side view, Becky, of you. So what we're going to do is we're going to be laying on our back and our feet are going to be flat, just exactly how Becky has it. And you're going to pick a side, right? We're going to start with the right side and we're just going to press over our chest like a bench press, right? And then that, yep. And then I'd even spin it just a little bit. Becky, there you go. And then that left hand's going to be over your tummy, right? We're just going to kind of push that over and that's going to keep us balanced. Okay. So from there, she's going to come all the way down. Elbow's going to touch the deck. Yep. And then we're going to come up. And what we don't want is we don't want to collapse at all, right? So she's going to come down looking good. Elbow touches the deck, goes right back up. Now, after the 30 seconds, we're going to swap. So then I would go ahead and put the dumbbell on your knee or just kind of swap like that. Becky, that's perfect. And then we get right back into the opposite hand. She's going to spin, right? And then she's going to come right back down and then press. Okay, so we're really going to be focusing on balance, coordination right now. Cool, Becky. Thank you. All right, so that's going to be step one or movement one. The next movement is going to be a bent over row. Okay, bent over row. It's going to be a single arm bent over row. Sometimes people call this like a lawnmower. So the big thing on this one is that there's the hand with the dumbbell, and then there's going to be the hand that's going to just pivot off your elbow, or your elbow is going to be on your knee. So if you can stand up, Becky, real quick.
You want a side view?
Yeah, side view would be cool. So this is actually a really good one. If you can tilt yourself a little bit, yeah, a little bit to the right or left. Yeah, right, yeah. There you go. Okay. Yeah, you turn towards me. Just a right there, right there. So the cool thing about that, guys, is the left
spotlight,
elbow.
Spotlight, Becky.
Yeah.
Spotlight.
Yep. Left elbow is going to be on your knee. Yep, and you're just going to let it – you're just like resting your body there. And the arm's going to be straight, back's going to be flat. And from there, she's just going to pull that elbow back, boom, and come right back down. And all we're doing, you guys, is focusing on one side, okay? So you're kind of leaning all your weight on your left side, and that right side just doing the work. And as she comes down, her shoulder still stays back, right? It's not like taking her to the deck. Cool. Thanks, Becky. Does that make sense, everybody? Adair?
Well, yeah, but we can't see Becky when you don't spotlight her.
Oh, you know that one thing I agreed to? Oh, my gosh.
Hey, okay.
There you go. Okay, so let's do it real quick, Becky. Let's go ahead and do that bent over row. Boom, back's flat. Beautiful. Okay, so that's going to be that bent over row. Okay. Let's go ahead and get on your back one more time, Becky. My apologies. Right, and think double dumbbell, but we only got one dumbbell. Right, so she's gonna press up, right? And as she comes down, yeah, and I would actually have it be out a little bit more, the elbow out a little bit more, Becky, so not so close to your body, yeah, just a little bit, right? We don't want it all the way out. There we go. Real strong, compact position. Good, and relax. Cool, thanks, Becky. Is that helpful, everybody?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So the one thing I just want to spotlight real quick is that we don't want the elbow out and we don't want the elbow tucked in. It's going to be kind of like in between. So it's in a real strong athletic position, right? This is kind of vulnerable. This is super vulnerable, but this is more really powerful. Okay. So let's do this, you guys. Let's go ahead, grab your dumbbells. Cielo, try that double dumbbell. Let me know how that works, okay? And let's do this. Let's get 5 presses on your left, 5 presses on your right. I'll have you guys stand up. I want you guys to get 5 single arm dumbbells on your left and then 5 single dumbbell pulls on your right. Cool? All right, let's go ahead and do that, you guys. Let's get a feel for that. Your grip strength, Cielo, is going to be awesome. There you go. Yeah, and that extra hand, guys, that's not doing anything, I find it super helpful, just kind of pulling across your stomach. Because they're a little bit – I always kind of feel off a little bit when I do this, so that kind of helps me stay a little bit balanced. Now, I was telling – so don't go too far back, Cielo. Yeah, there we go. I was telling Cielo that when we ever get to a point that we have dumbbells and maybe that they are maybe not as heavy because she was saying she has 2 weights. She usually uses 15s or 20s at the gym. We can always slow a repetition down to create like a tempo. There we go. Yep. And just kind of put like all your weight on that elbow, Cielo, that goes on your knee. Yeah. Arm straight. Nice, Becky. And then one thing just to keep in mind, you guys, is that shoulder joint. Think about your shoulder. It's always going to be above your hip. So if you ever find yourself like a dare, kind of like you're bending over too far, just kind of lift that chest up a little bit, almost like the best deadlift on planet Earth. Right, super flat back. All right. So let's go and do this, you guys. We're going to do 4 sets, okay? We're going to do 30 seconds of max dumbbell floor presses on your right. And then we're going to swap over the next 30 seconds. We're going to do it on your left. And then we're going to go ahead and stand up. We're going to do 30 seconds of a single arm bent over row. And then we're going to swap to the other side. And then we're going to go ahead and rest. Okay. I know it says about a minute and a half rest. Let's go off of the first set. I think a minute's going to be fine, but you guys let me know. Okay. And then what we're going to keep track of today is all of the repetitions that we do. Okay. So it's not like as fast as you can, but just as quality as you can, but we're still going to keep track of reps. Sound good, you guys? All right. Let's go ahead, lay down, and I'm going to let you guys pick your side. Pick whatever side you guys want to start with, and all I'm going to say is switch, okay? Like, I'm left-handed. I usually start with my weak side, so I have something promising to start finish with. All right, everybody, here we go in 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Just nice and smooth. Remember, we don't want the elbow too far out. We also don't want it too tucked in. There we go. We got 10 more seconds of this. Nice and controlled. 3, 2, go ahead and swap sides. Now, let's just say you guys came to class and you're like, hey, you know, I don't have dumbbells for this. What I would have you do is either on your toes or on your knees for push-ups. We would just simply do a minute of push-ups, kind of with a slow tempo. All right. In 5, 4, 3, and rotate. Go ahead and stand up. We're going to do those bent over rows. Get right into that bent over row once you've stood up. Backs are flat. There we go. And just nice and smooth. There we go. Good. Lift that chest up a little bit more, Adair, if you can. Just really proud chest. And guys, don't think about going super fast. Just think about super smooth. 3, 2, swap hands. There we go. Seconds. Remember, keep them chest lift up. 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. All right, so let's do that minute rest. And then you guys can let me know how you feel about that. All right. So what we'll do is I'm gonna have you guys sit on this a little bit, but if you would recommend a book or a movie, what would that book, that movie be during this time that we may possibly have a little bit extra time home? Okay, so we're gonna go through the whole series. You guys can kind of sit on that. What would you recommend? All right, 15 seconds, you guys. We're going to go right back into those presses. Cielo, how's those dumbbells? Yeah. Let's go push-ups. Let's go hand release push-ups on this next one. Okay? And begin, everybody. I'm going to get you, Cielo. Say that again.
By hand release push-ups, what exactly do you mean?
So you're going to come all the way down to the floor, let go of the floor,
and then push back through. Up.
Yeah, I'm going to have you do that for the remaining minute.
Okay.
Right? Yep. And then we'll count those repetitions. There we go. Nice, Becky. Good tempo. Looks like a good weight. 2, 1, and dumbbell swap. Cielo, go ahead and keep on moving. Ten seconds, you guys. And 3, 2, 1, and rotate. Let's go ahead and pop on up. Let's get to those dumbbell rows.
I've got a 30-pound kettlebell that I can use for the rows if that's...
That would be cool. Okay. That would be totally cool.
Cool.
Yeah, go for it. All right, guys, 10 more seconds. Yeah, that's going to force you. Yeah, there you go, Cielo. Ah, that's way better. 3, 2, 1, and rotate. Good. Keeping that chest up, Adair. There we go. Think about, you guys, that you're pulling through your fingertips. And you're pulling with your tips of your finger. Nice, Becky. There you go, Dan. 10 seconds, you guys. Yeah, Cielo, that looks a lot better. 3, 2, and rest. Okay, so if there was something to recommend, movie or a book, go ahead and unmute, you guys. I think I was able to unmute Becky. All right, there we go. So Becky, what is your, what's your recommendation?
This year I read Trevor Noah's autobiography. It's like My Life is a Crime or something like that.
Yeah.
Super hilarious. And okay. I recommend that because it's just like, is the only book that I've just started like laughing while reading.
Okay. Okay. We have 20 seconds. What about you, Cielo?
I've been kind of reading 3 books right now. It depends on what you kind of like. So if you're into fiction, I really am into Stephen King novels. So I'm reading The Outsider right now.
All right. Really cool. All right.
Yeah.
What about you, Adair?
Well, I'm reading The Water Dancer by Ta-Nehisi Coates, which is gorgeous and beautiful, but I'm not reading it very quickly.
Okay. Dan?
Apocalypse Now.
Actually, you know what Dan is reading? Melissa Clark's French cooking book, 1 page a day.
Ooh. All right, you guys, let's get set into that press position. 5, 4, 3, 2, and here we go. All right. Nice and smooth. I want you guys to feel that press through that chest. Nice, Cielo. 20 seconds, you guys. 3, 2, 1, and all right, rotate. Doing good, Cielo, doing good. Nice. Outstanding, you guys. 15 seconds. All right, in 5, 4, 3, and all right, rest, rotate. Here we go. Bent over row. Really flex those abs tight. Maybe push those abs out. Really keep that chest up, right? From that side view, we still want to see that lower lumbar curve. anytime that we lean too far forward, we aren't able to see that back support at all. So we want to keep it up, chest up. 3, 2, 1, and rotate. Remember, soften those knees a little bit. And if you can't pull it all the way up, Cielo, because you're starting to like over rotate a little bit, just kind of pull to the part that you can go up. There we go. Just like that. Yep. Backs are flat, you guys. Breath. You're holding that breath. Three, two, one, and rotate to a rest. We're going to rest 1 full minute, you guys. And then we'll do this for one more time. Cielo, how's those push-ups? Is it a little bit better? Yeah.
Better than having to grip in a weird way.
I know. I saw you had that grip. I was like, that looks uncomfortable.
It's so uncomfortable.
Yeah. Well, good. All right. 20 seconds. Becky, how far is Nick running today?
Am I on mute? Okay. probably, oh wait, I hear. No, maybe I don't hear. Oh. Maybe 4 miles up Queen Anne Hill.
Okay.
He's copying me because I went for a run on Sunday and he feels left out.
He can't be outdid by you.
Yeah.
All right, everybody, here we go. 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Single arm presses. So as a sneak preview, you guys, we are going to have some bent over rows in today's workout. So thinking about the dumbbell that you're using for this workout. 3, 2, 1, and rotate. Thinking about, are you going to use the same weight? All right. Nice and smooth, you guys. There we go, Cielo. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and rotate. All right, we're going into bent over rows. All right, soften those knees a little bit. Chest is up. There we go. Again, pulling through those fingertips. Three, two, one, and rotate. Good, nice and smooth, you guys. Nice work there, Dan. Nice, Adair. Good, keep that chest up a little bit more, Cielo. Yeah, just like that. Really flex your guys' abs tight. 10 seconds. Always tend to flex and kind of push out a little bit. That helps me keep my chest up or hold my chest up. 3, 2, and stop. All right, so let's do this, you guys. Let's go ahead and type the amount of all your repetitions. So all your presses, all your rows, all together. We're gonna just add the numbers together. There we go. Nicely done, Adair. So as you guys are typing in, I'm just going to kind of preview what's next is we're going to have a double AMRAP, right? We're going to work for 8 minutes. And we are going to, we're going to have 10 double dumbbell swings. So if you have a kettlebell, that's going to be an awesome option also. We're going to do 10 burpees. And then we're going to do 10 bent over rows. So what I'd like to have on that one, if you guys have 2 dumbbells, awesome. We'll go ahead and get, 10 bent over rows. But ideally, if we just go with one dumbbell that has some significant weight, five on each side, that would be fine. Like that kettlebell would be perfect for UCLO. Becky, you have what, the 35? The what?
25.
Does that feel okay?
Yeah, I think it'll be okay.
Yeah. Okay.
For dumbbell swings, it'll probably be too light. I might use the 50.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Totally cool. What about you guys, Adair and Dan? You guys good on weight?
Oh, what is it?
So for the bent over row, if we have something that would be good for single arms, you know, five and five, but if you also, you could also do double dumbbell too, if you wanted to.
Wait, I'm very confused. Okay.
Yeah. So I was just going over the bent over row. So we have the dumbbell swing. Yeah.
Okay. So the dumbbell swing can be either a kettlebell or two dumbbells or one dumbbell or whatever.
Yeah. Whatever. Yeah. Whatever you have. Whatever you have.
Okay. And then burpees and then bent over.
Yeah.
What are you using,
Dan? And Becky, are you okay if I highlight you again for the demo? Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to mute everybody. So Becky, let's get her spotlighted again. Yeah, so let's go over the double dumbbell swing, and we'll go ahead and let's just make it a kettlebell swing or a dumbbell swing.
Okay.
The big thing really quick, you guys, is just to remember is that pick up the weight in front of you, right? And from there, yeah, that's perfect. We're just going to, one, have that back flat, tilt that kettlebell a little bit towards you, and then from there, we're going to pull it right through our legs and stand right up, right? And so a Russian kettlebell swing, give about two more of those, Becky, you know, maybe above those hips, chest level, and then once you're done, you're going to return it right back to where you started. So the big thing is we have rhythm, but we also have that flat back, and we're not getting jerked around at all, okay? Cool, Becky. I think that is perfect. Thank you.
Yeah.
So let's do this, you guys. Let's grab your guys' dumbbells or kettlebells, and let's go ahead and get 10 kettlebell swings or dumbbell swings. Again, if you have two dumbbells, you can definitely widen up that base, right? There you go. Now, when I say keep that weight as close to your body as possible, that really is mean like keep it as close to your crotch as possible, because that is your center of mass and that is where that power is coming from. And anytime that weight gets away from your hips, all it does is has you kind of using other muscles just to make sure that that weight doesn't get far away from you and we start to feel a little tweaks in funny areas of our body. So
Scott, to keep it closer to you, does that mean bend your legs less essentially?
To keep it, you know what you want to do is you want to use those back muscles a little bit more so that this part, you pulling, is going to be using those muscles to keep it a little bit closer.
Okay.
Is that helpful?
Yeah.
Okay. And you definitely could soften those knees a little bit to get that kettlebell underneath your body a little bit more too. Okay. All right. Grab some water real quick and then let us get moving. Perfect. Okay. Okie doke. Okay, so we are going to go 8 minutes. We're going to start with the dumbbell swings. We're then going to go ahead and do 10 burpees. And then we're going to go ahead and do 10 dumbbell bent over rows. Again, you can do, if it's having a heavier weight, five on your left, five on your right. And if you'd like to use the double dumbbells, by all means, that's going to be an option too. All right, so once we're done with that 8 minutes, we're going to then rest for 2 minutes, and then we're doing that all over again. So what we're tracking today, everybody, is total rounds and reps. Okay, so total rounds and reps. Okay, here we go. Give me a thumbs up if we are ready to go. Dan's ready. Ciela's ready. All right, Becky's ready. All right, everybody, here we go in 3, 2, 1. And here we go. Kettlebell swings, dumbbell swings. Nice. Yep, just like that. And especially as we're going down between our legs, you guys, looking straight ahead of you, that is a helpful tip to keep that chest up. There we go. There we go. Great burpees, you guys. Nice, Ciela. Repping that 50. Is that a 50? Yeah, right on. There we go. Good. Soften those knees a little bit more as we go down. Good. Remember, everything's tight, right? Midsection's always tight, no matter what movement, what we're doing. Nice, Becky. Good flow. Don't want to be slipping too much around. Nice, Adair. Kettlebell swings looking awesome. So with that bell, you guys, as we start to come up and that bell starts to get away from us, to squeeze those quads, stand up tall, squeeze your glutes. And as it comes down, it's kind of free falling, but pull it right underneath your body. Keep it as close to your body as possible. Yep. There we go. Nice, Ciela. Yeah, leaning forward is perfect, right? Looking straight, you guys. All right, we are almost about 3 minutes in. Nice, Adair. There we go. Getting super flush against the floor. Yep, and as time goes on, you guys, and you start to get tired with those burpees, we can always step up, we can always step out. Finding a tempo of those burpees is super important. You know, so we don't blast ourselves in the beginning and then it becomes super slow at the end. So something that we can kind of walk ourselves through. Good. Really lift that chest up, Ciela. Yeah, there we go. Feel that difference? Yeah. Think about each breath, each pull. One breath, one pull. All right. Halfway in, everybody. 4 minutes in. Nice, Dan. Nice work, Becky. Here we go. Here we go. All right. 3 minutes left, everybody. You got it, Becky. You got it. Now take that deep breath. All right. There we go. Keep going, guys. Keep going. Good work. Good work. Good tempo, Cielo. There we go. Remember, set that back down, then pull. There we go. Nice, Becky. Keep it going. Keep it going. 2 minutes, you guys. Yep. There we go, Cielo. That's way better. And abs tight, everybody. Abs tight. All right, 2 minutes. Here we go. Here we go. Shake it out. Catch that breath. There we go. So before we pick up that kettlebell, right, before we start to swing it, we want to set our back, right? We want to set our back. Make sure we're flat. We're braced, and at that point, we're then gonna stand up and get up off the deck. But we can't pick up that kettlebell until we're set. Almost there, you guys, 1:15 remaining. Okay, here we go, 1 minute, you guys. There you go. Pulling that elbow back, Becky. Think it like you're pulling it back behind you. There you go. Just like that. Welcome back, Nick. Almost there. 30 seconds, everybody. 30 seconds. Okay, here we go. Here we go. 20 seconds. Nick, just in time for our last 8 minute AMRAP. 15 seconds. 10 seconds. All right, you guys. 5, 4, 3, and rest. Okay, so we have 2 minutes to rest, everybody. Okay, so write down your round and reps. So as we're resting right now, you guys, we're maybe getting our water. We're just catching our breath. Let's be sure to, because eventually what we'll do is we'll type it all, or we'll add them all up. Nice job, Cielo. Okay, so Cielo, what we'll do is we'll add round one and then round two together once we're all said and done. Nicely done. Okay, 1 more minute, you guys. Okay, 30 seconds. Now we're gonna do that same exact thing that we just got done doing, okay? So we're gonna have that dumbbell swing, 10 burpees, and then the 10 bent over rows. Okay. 10 seconds, everybody. All right, here we go in 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Nice setup, everybody. Backs are flat. There we go. Nice, Becky. Yep. Pull that bell as really close to your body, but underneath you. Shoulder's going to go a little bit more forward than you want. You're probably going to think. And then we want to find that tempo, you guys. Find that pace that we can just hold. Perfect. Looking good, you guys. And then once we're done with those burpees, we're going to go right into those bent over rows. And that's the one of the part where we don't want to rush that one, right? We want to be nice, crisp movements. There we go. All right, so set those backs, keep that chest up. There we go, Dare. Good setup, Becky. Good flat back. Nice job. Atta girl, Cielo. Nice, Dan. Good. Slow down just a little bit, Cielo, right? Nice and crisp. There we go. Chest up. There you go. Nice, Becky. Nice, Dan. You're looking good, Dan. Okay. Yep. Nice. Find that breathing pattern, you guys. Especially with those kettlebell swings and especially with those bent over rows. Take one breath, one rep. Keep it going. All right. 5 minutes left. You got it. Remember with those burpees, right? Instead of just completely stopping, we just slow the tempo down. Instead of jumping out, we walk it out. Maybe instead of jumping up, we step it up. And then when you feel like you're ready to get back into it, then you do it again. Start jumping. There we go. So set that back, Cielo, right? Get it set. There we go. Nice. Good weight. Nice. Think deep breath and brace those abs hard, Becky, as you pull. There we go. Yeah, and you have to break it up in smaller reps. That's perfect. You got this, Dan. All right. Keep it moving, everybody. Keep it moving. Super proud of you guys starting your morning like this. Especially Nick going out for that run. Yeah. This is the secret, you guys, of feeling awesome in the morning. There we go. All right, you guys, we have just over 3 minutes remaining. Come on, Keep pushing, you guys. You got it. You got it. There we go. There we go. Keeping those chests up with those bent over rows. The common thing is to kind of fall forward, rounding that back. Just really flex those abs, really push through those abs, keeping that back flat. All right, here we go. We have 2 minutes left. Good. Lift that rib cage up just a little bit more, Cielo. There we go. Yeah, there we go. 90 seconds. There we go, Dare. You got it. There we go, Dan. Keep pushing, man. Keep pushing. Yep. Just think pulling that elbow back just a little bit back. Boom. Yep. There we go. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. So remember, when we put those dumbbells or those kettlebells on the deck, right, reset it to the floor with a flat back, just like we're about to pull the bell or the dumbbell off the deck. I think we want to pull it off the floor with a flat back, and we want to return it with a flat back. All right, 1 minute, you guys. Come on. You got it. Really be careful with that pull, Becky, that you pull with that elbow, not like that into a shrug, right? So even if you have to do a half rep, that's totally fine. All right, 40 seconds. Come on, guys. You got it. There we go, you guys. 20 seconds. Come on. Keep going. Don't stop, guys. 15 seconds. 10 seconds. We're almost there, guys. Keep it moving, guys. Keep it moving. Don't stop yet. 5, 4, 3, 2, and stop. Nicely done, you guys. Nicely done. All right. Let's make sure that we go to the comment section, you guys. Let's go ahead.
What do you have on that run?
There we go. Let's go ahead and put your total rounds. Okay, total rounds. So if you got 5 rounds the first time and 5 rounds the second time, right? That would be a total of 10 rounds. And then you just add those reps too. So whatever your repetition count is, you just add the reps together too. Nicely done today, you guys. I feel like my big takeaway was learning how to spotlight somebody, Adair. So thank you. Outstanding. All right. So let's go through a final like icebreaker a little bit, you guys. But what is something that you're looking forward to today? Adair, can I start with you today?
Yes.
What are you looking forward to?
Interviewing someone I want to hire. Even though we almost have a hiring freeze, I think I'm going to get this done before they institute a hiring freeze. Yes.
All right. Yeah, very cool. What about you, Dan?
I'm going to stake out a new garden bed.
New garden bed. Becky.
Nick and I are installing an automated irrigation system for our
plots.
Whoa,
that's big time. Nick, what is yours?
Work on hire.
I thought there was a hiring freeze.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to the same thing. It's nice and sunny out. Also, I went for a run and Becky beat me. So.
All right. Hey. What about you, Cielo?
I have to work today, so.
Yeah. Hey, that's good. That's good. Very cool, you guys. I think some of you guys know this, but I had this little side thing that I started a while ago with, called myself the Junk Hunk. But anyways, everybody's cleaning their houses and getting ready to dump everything. And so I'm looking forward to kind of playing outside in the sun a little bit. So kind of gets myself dirty and earns my dinner. So, all right. Well, you guys, we will be here tomorrow, same time, same place. And then there's 5 o'clock class in the evening also with Rory. So let's just say you missed the morning on Wednesday. Rory's in the evening on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So, and then also, guys, feel free to share this out to people that, you know, maybe aren't Stoneway members right now, like Cielo just joined the gym right this week, so you know, awesome, man. Our tribe can still grow while all of this is still going on, you guys, so don't hesitate to kind of reach out to somebody.
Look for invite Peter them Dammon tomorrow morning. Scott,
what's that?
Look for Peter Dammon tomorrow morning.
Oh,
par excellence.
All right, that's Adair's brother, everybody. Cool. So, you guys have a great day. I'll see you guys tomorrow. And if you guys need anything, reach out to me and we'll connect.
Okay. Cool.
Thanks, Scott. Right.
See you guys. Have a great day.
Yeah.